Welcome to this webinar with ProThoughts about the PMP online training. I think we just waited for a few minutes for the folks to join in. I think let's start with the session. The topic is talking about the PMP trainings, and specifically we'll focus on online, though we'll compare it with the classroom trainings and all other things. But before that, I'll just give you a brief about myself and the company, and then we'll talk about the PMP online. So I hope you are able to view my screen. I just wanted to introduce myself before, so that you know whom you are talking to. My name is Arvind Nahata, and working with ProThoughts Solutions as a director and partner. So you can see my qualifications and the experience. I have around 17 plus, now it's touching 18 years of experience. Mentored around 2,000 working professionals across the globe, and then I've conducted 90 plus PMP workshops. It's going to touch hitting century soon, and then I've conducted 5,000 hours of project management workshops across corporate trainings, PMP workshops all inclusive. Have around 26,000 LinkedIn followers and work with a couple of tier one companies and a couple of clients that you can see the names and the different types of projects that I've worked on. And I have a PMP certification with me, and then you can see the qualifications. I did my post-graduation from US, did my engineering from India, and then post-graduation from US, worked in US for around 10 years before shifting back permanently to India. So right now I'm conducting this session from India itself. Okay, so that's the background about myself. And I'll just give a brief about the company as well. ProThoughts Solutions before we start and talking about. So ProThoughts is a organization which is only into project management. So we do a lot of things into project management, not only trainings. So the way we are visualizing our company to the brand to be created is, tomorrow if somebody thinks about project management, they find ProThoughts as a one-stop solution for any of their needs. Succeed with the project is the motto, and we try to, it's the training part, if I have to talk about, because it's about PMP, we are specifically talking about in this. So we try to coach the candidates, not only for clearing the exam, but you need to apply this knowledge at work. So most of our sessions are talking about the practical applications as well. Okay, so that's about ProThoughts. We were among the top 100 startups in 2015 to look out for by the Times Group. So that's one. And then these are the three primary things that we do. We have expanded into many other things. So first part is the training part. Second is the project management softwares like MS Project, Primavera, Project Insight, several of those software implementations we have done. So we are the only institution in India and Middle East who can implement the Project Insight software. So that's one specifically associated with us. And then consulting and advisory services, only the project management consulting, we do provide that also to several corporates. And plus many other things. These are the three primary areas. Okay. Okay, that was about, in short, about the company. Now coming back into what our main focus is today, the PMP trainings. Okay. So if we talk about, first of all, before we get into the PMP online, you need to understand why a PMP training is needed. Means PMI, the governing body who certifies you for PMP, they could have just given you the study materials, the PMBOK, the Rita Mulcahy book, or whichever study materials you want to prepare based on, and they could have asked to study by yourself and take the exam. But they are mandating this. If you look at it, this is one of the mandatory steps in the PMI PMP process, where you have to go through these 35 hours of training for project management. And PMI mandates that. You need to have those 35 hours of training. Without that, you cannot pay the exam fees, cannot take a date of the exam. And if you need to understand why that 35 PDUs, they call it as 35 PDUs, professional development units, it's basically the 35 hours of training. Now, why the mandate is one, if you need to understand, before I get into the bullet points, you need to understand PMP is one of the toughest certifications in the world. It's among the top 10 professional certifications in terms of toughness. And if you try to prepare it by yourself, believe me, half of you will drop out of it halfway through. Then PMI knows that very well. And so what, and if you, even if you don't drop out, if you prepare by yourself, believe me, it will take you much longer time to prepare by yourself. That's why these 35 hours of training is mandatory. So it substantially shortens your PMP preparation effort. If I have to give you the numbers, if you're really smart enough to understand the concepts and grasping ability is pretty good, still, if you try to do it by yourself, it will take you almost a year to be prepared for PMP, if you go through the entire process. But with this 35 hours of training, you are able to get the PMP certification done in less than 1 year to 3 months. That's the time saving of an individual if you are really getting into a good training program. So that's one. So 9 months of your time is saved. If you convert into a monetary terms, it's a big savings. A lot of people try to do it by themselves. If they have a 35 PDUs and they try to apply shortcuts and they drop out, most of them drop out. So PMI knows that very well. So that's why they mandated it. So now these 35 PDUs are mandatory. Now, one is to shorten your PMP preparation effort for an individual, for a candidate. That's one. Even if you prepare and take the exam without going through these 35 PDUs, what you will do, you might not be able to clear the exam. One, because the way the PMI wants you to think is like a project manager, because the exam is designed in such a way that it will be, I'll show you in one of the slides in the subsequent slides, that it will be testing a lot of your skill sets which a project manager needs to have. So you need to start thinking like a project manager. If you are still not thinking like a project manager, but you have all the knowledge that PMI wants you to give, believe me, you will not be able to crack the PMP. So that thought process needs to be aligned with the PMI, the way the PMI way of doing things, the how PM project manager needs to think. So that thought process is what, that is one of our primary focuses in the workshops, in the training workshops which we conduct for PMP, that you start thinking like a PM has to think. Okay, and then you need to have a clarity on the next steps. We talk about a lot of strategy planning, and we do a lot of strategy planning, all the exam information. There are a lot of misconceptions, a lot of people talking about different ways, different things on the internet, and at times people come to us saying, I'm confused, because somebody's saying go to east to crack PMP, somebody's saying go to west to crack PMP. They are exactly opposite, and both of them saying we are successful. Now what to do? So there are a lot of things on the web. If you start searching about on how to crack PMP, everybody's approach is different. So that's where you need an individual attention, where what works for you, that you need to know. So that's where these training workshops are effective. You need to have gone through. So we normally talk about in these training workshops all the different strategy plannings and everything, how it needs to be done. And obviously everybody will customize a little bit based on that. Okay, so those things also you need to know, and you need yourself, you will not have an idea of what are the next steps, how to do it. At times, if you feel you have, still there might be some misconceptions. So that's a risky thing, because it's a lot of money that is going into the entire process. I'll talk about that in a while too. Okay, so finding your gaps is the next important thing, and fixing them. And to avoid failure, we talk about all the reasons why failures happens in PMP, and how to avoid them. All those things are a part of the strategy planning which we do in the workshop, which is very important. We say, if you want to succeed, keep your enemies closer. So you need to know where you can fail, why you may not clear the exam. If you know that, then only you can work towards it. So we work towards it. We help you on that. Okay. So these are the things that a PMP training is supposed to do. Okay. So these are the things why PMP training is needed. In short, there could be a few more reasons, but these are the few of the important reasons which we are talking about. Okay. Now, this is one of the reasons you don't want to fail in PMP. I think this slide is a little slower. So, okay. So there are several reasons. If you start thinking why a candidate don't clears a PMP, what can be the reasons? Half of the reasons will be linked with probably that they are not attended an effective training program. Okay, so that is something, is one of the primary reasons, or most of the reasons will link out to that. Okay, so you need to do this analysis very effectively before you go for the exam. Okay. Then the next slide, I'm just waiting for the slide to refresh on the screen so that I can talk about it. Okay, so most of you probably who are looking for PMP are experienced people. I assume that none of you are freshers out of the college attending this session. So if you have experienced people who have worked in the industry for a long time now, you have not studied for a long time. So again, going through a textbook might be a big headache for you. So that is something you need to understand, that PMP is not about memorizing the stuff. Believe me, with age, that capability goes down, and PMI knows that very well. So it's all about understanding the concepts, grasping it, and applying that knowledge effectively in the exam. So it's all about understanding the concepts. That's what we focus on in our training programs. Okay, so this is one of the blunders which candidates do. They try to mug up and memorize everything, and they feel that, oh, it's not my cup of cake, and they drop out. It's no rocket science. PMP is no rocket science. If you know how to crack it, it becomes very easy. It's just about having a good strategy in place. Okay. And then these are the things that, okay, I'm just waiting for the slide to refresh. Okay, so if you see on this screen, there are four things which we are talking about, which the PMP exam evaluates in you. One is the experience. The middle one, the knowledge, is the foremost. Obviously, if you don't know the content of PMP syllabus, you will struggle to crack. But along the knowledge is not enough. Along with that, you need to have experience. It will be testing your experience, your analytical skills, how you apply this knowledge and experience to work. And the fourth thing is the patience. They will try to frustrate you in the exam, and they want you to get frustrated. It's a process of elimination. So you need to know how to bypass that. When you're working as a project manager, you might get frustrated at times, and they don't like project managers to get frustrated. You are not a correct candidate to get certified if you are getting frustrated. So that patience is also tested substantially in that exam. So these are the things that are tested. We'll talk about that in the workshop, but you need to know these things in short. Okay, and the weightage of the exam, you need to know a lot of things about the exam also as well. The weightage of the exam, what are the important where the questions come from, more and less and all, so that you can create a strategy. We're not getting into the details of it, but just giving you a glimpse. I just clicked the slide twice. So coming back, so if you see the variation, the number of questions from each different areas of project management, I'm not going to talk in detail about this. We'll cover in detail when you in any of the training programs, but right now just giving a glimpse of it. Okay, so you need to know the weightage, and plus how to tackle this weightage is separately. Each area have a different strategy in place. Okay, and then coming to the costs involved. So again, let the slide get refreshed. Okay, so coming to the costs involved, if you see, there are three costs. The bottom two, if you look at, they are the PMI charges. One is the PMI membership that you need to take. It's $139, $129 plus $10 is one-time registration fee. So $139 is an annual membership that you need to take, and the exam fees will be $405. So $405 plus $139, it's around $550 that you need to pay to PMI before you take the exam. And on top of that, the training cost, for which these 35 hours plus, we normally sell it as a complete package. So it varies from all the way from $20 to $300, depending on what you are getting in the package. Like the biggest packages, which goes all the way from $250 to $300, that includes all the study materials, plus the training, plus the support throughout your preparation time, the mock exams, a lot of things are inclusive. But if you just want to attend the training, you might get it for $20 to $100 as well. So depending on the effectiveness of the training, the prices can vary between, although it can be as low as $20 to as high as $100 to $150 only training. If you need the whole package, it might go till $300. So that's the range. Now you can convert these dollars into your local currencies. So these are the three charges. If you add up, it's anywhere the total budget that you need to have for PMP needs to be anywhere between $600 to $900. So that's the cost that you should be looking at if you're looking to get PMP certified. Okay, now all the different variations, all the different types of the way the PMP trainings can be conducted. One is a physical classroom training. That's the traditional way of training, in the classroom, physically the trainers are present, the you need to be physically present there. It's a physical face-to-face interaction between you and the trainer. All the folks attending are sitting with you in person. It is the most expensive because it comes at a cost, but it is the most effective training, the classroom trainings. And this is something we really recommend. Okay, if you are able to find a classroom training close to your place, this is the most suggested way of training. But nowadays, what's picking up is the online trainings. The reason behind, I'll just talk in a while, but let's talk about the different variations. The next slide talks about the pros and cons about each of them. Okay, so the online training could be of two types. One is a live online training, where live streaming is happening. The training, the trainer is talking in person live and you are listening to it live, but you don't have to be physically present. It's all, you need an internet connection, just like this one. Right now, what's we are happening, it's a live online training. Just like this way, it's a live online trainings for PMP as well. Okay, and then the second one is, I could just do a recording of this and I could give this recorded sessions to anybody at any time at their own leisure time and space. So that could be another way. So there are recorded sessions, recorded videos, which are given access to you, but then you cannot ask questions. You cannot, right now we'll have a Q&A session. You can raise hand and I can address the queries right away. So all those options will be there. But in the recorded session, it's just about listening to the videos and that's it. Because we talked about raising the hands, let me see if anybody had any queries so far. I don't see anybody raising hands. Okay, so I'll wait for the Q&A at the end. So these are the three variations. The classroom training and the online has two different sub variations, live online trainings and the recorded sessions given access to. Now, the recorded sessions are the least expensive, but the least effective as well. Okay, not recommended, but at times, let's get into the next slide where we'll talk about all the when to do this, when not to do this. You know. Okay, just waiting for the next slide. Okay, so now the PMP online training, which is the topic of today. So when to consider that? One, you should consider that when you need flexibility. Okay, so for the recorded sessions, you get much more flexibility because you can listen to those videos at your own convenient time. Okay, but the classroom trainings have the least flexibility. They are done at a predefined time. You need to be there at those times, else you miss those sessions. Okay, so that's an important part, which is a benefit on the online part. Okay, so you get the flexibility. And when price is a constraint, because this option is cheaper, obviously. So whenever you have a price constraint, you can go for an online training. It will be cheaper than the other two options, the classroom session. So that these are the two primary reasons when you should consider the online training. And the third one, which is not here in the slide, probably you might be considering, is geographical constraints. In your geography, in your location, in your city, in your town, if you feel that there are no live classroom trainings and you cannot travel, then you don't have a choice. You have to go with the online training. Okay, so that's something. If you are in smaller towns, smaller cities, probably you will not find a PMP classroom training happening. They mostly happen in the big towns, big cities. So that might be one constraint because of which you might be opting for an online training. But the fallouts, why you should not go for the online training is one, because no personal attention. The trainer is not connected with you in person, so there will be a limitation because of that. Otherwise, you are meeting in person during the lunch times. You will be talking to him later after the workshops also. He'll be supporting you for a lot of things. And a personal relationship starts between you and the trainer, you and the colleagues. So a lot of socialization can happen. You can create groups, study groups there itself. And it's a lot of benefits in the classroom training. That's why we normally recommend that. Okay, so that's one thing. No relationship bonding with the classmates and trainer. We just discussed that. Okay, and then the third thing is you will have to need to put much more effort because they are less effective, and at times the classroom training count size is also bigger. So what happens is a lot of concerns are not addressed. So you might find that if there are like the big institutions who are conducting the online trainings, if you go with them, you will find 40, 50, 60 70 people dialing in those sessions, and it becomes practically impossible for the trainer to address each and every query. They try to address each and every query, but say, for example, candidate number one asks a question and the trainer answers that. Again, the same question is asked maybe an hour later by another candidate. The trainer may not be probably answering it, but that answer will be repeated here in the classroom trainings, because the size of the, you will not find a 50, 60 candidates attending it. The classroom trainings normally which we conduct is of a batch size of 20, 30, not more than 20, 25. Very rarely we have done it for 30, 35, but mostly the batch size is of 20, 25, which is also on the higher side we are talking about. So it will never be 50 or 60 or 70 as such. So that's something. So there is a lot of personal attention given, plus each of your queries will be addressed very effectively. We don't move ahead unless each of the concerns are not addressed. So that is something helps you. So when you walk out of the PMP training in a classroom, you are very confident of what you have got into, and you have a very good understanding of the concepts very well. And it becomes very easy for you to crack PMP. Time is saved also, plus a lot of benefits like that are happening. So that's why classroom trainings are preferential, but at times you don't have a choice, or there might be constraint because of the price or geography, or you just need the flexibility. If those are the concerns, you might go for the online training. And the next slide, if you instead of me walking you through, we have discussed most of the points here. I'll suggest you just read through it. Just go through that instead of me speaking about it. I'll keep that slide open on the screen for a while. So I hope you are getting the points. I'll take up the Q&A. If you have any doubts, you can raise the hand, or at the end in the question and answers, I'll take up questions too. So both the types of online training, one is recorded videos and one is live streaming. Both are online and e-learnings. Okay, I hope that you have gone through it. So so further, if you have any informations, you can reach us out, you can mail us, you can go to our website prothoughts.com and raise any queries with us. We'll be more than happy to address any concerns, any queries that you might have. We have offices in India, two offices, one in Mumbai, one in Pune. So I operate from the Pune office, so I have given the Pune office numbers, so Pune India office number. So if you have any queries, you can reach us out. You can add a +91 for the India code if you are abroad, so the country code +91 on top of this. So you can note down the number. If you have any queries, you can always connect with us on these contact details. I think it's reflected now on the screen. So add a +91 on the phone numbers for the India country code. Else you can always mail us, go to our website and raise an inquiry. And so that was about it. So it was a short session, though. It was just talking about why you should be going for PMP online and when you should be going for the other options, classroom online versus the recorded sessions. Online, normally we always call it as a live streaming. One is an online thing. Live streaming is a e-learning. So those are the three options. And based on this, I think you at least my target of this session today was to give you a clarity about what to expect in PMP and which options to select from, pros and cons for each of the options. So considering this, if you have any questions, please let me know now. So any questions? No questions. That's really nice. I think I addressed everything. So if you have any queries, just so I'm not getting any hands raised, neither in the questions column I can see any questions typed in. So I think it was just a 35-minute session, around a half an hour session. So if you have any queries, I'll just open that one slide one more time, the contact details. So if you want to note down and raise a query separately with us, you can always do that. So you can give us a call, email us, or okay. So Suresh has a question. Okay, so Suresh is asking that how much experience is required to go for PMP. So to go for PMP, the requirement from PMI is that you need to have, if you have a bachelor's degree, so if you have a 10 plus 2 plus a bachelor's degree, then you need to have at least 4500 hours of project management experience. 4500 hours, if you calculate in terms of years, it comes down to approximately 3 years of project management experience. And if you don't have a bachelor's degree, if you just have a 10 plus 2 or just a diploma holder, then you need to have 7500 hours, which comes down to a little more than that, maybe 4 to 5 years of project management experience. So that much experience is a must. So a fresher out of the college cannot opt for, if you have zero experience or less than 2, 3, 4 years of experience, you cannot go for PMP. Because the process, in the application process, it will get rejected. You need to submit an application before you after the workshop is completed, showing your experience and the 35 hours proof to the PMI. So in that, if you don't have the experience, it will get rejected. At least go into the query mode if they find something is fishy. Show. So we normally help you with the application process also if you take the entire package with us. So we will ensure if we take you, we'll check your experience upfront. If you qualify, only then we'll take you, and then we'll take that accountability of getting your application approved. We'll review your application before you actually submit it to PMI. So that way we help you out on that. But unless you don't have the experience, it will not go through with PMI. So experience is in terms of hours, 4,500 hours with a bachelor's degree, 7,500 hours without a bachelor's degree, which is like 3 years with bachelor's or 5 years without bachelor's degree in project management. So good that you asked that. So any other question? So Suresh, just confirm if I answered your question.
Hello.
Yes, Suresh.
Yeah, actually that I got it, that I mean 10 plus without 10 plus, I mean diploma holder or B holder, what is the experience required? But if without without any institution training, if I want to opt for PMP, how the evaluation process goes from PMI, whether I have a valid industry experience of that much hours or not?
Which training you're talking about, the 35 hours training?
Yeah. That PDU
you need to have. Without, there is no shortcut for that. There is no alternative for that. There are two things which is for must is needed. One is the number of hours with bachelor, without bachelor, whatever it is, but certain 100 hours of experience is for sure needed. And along with that, this 35 hours training is also a mandatory thing. Now, the different ways of getting this 35 hours is, one, you can get it by getting associated with one of the REPs, like registered education providers, like ProThought is one of the REPs, global REPs. We conduct it in India and abroad in multiple locations. So that is one. Other option is you get into a lot of MBA courses, and MBA in project management, if you do, then several of those courses qualify for those these hours. So you need to attend those the lectures in the MBA courses, and then you need to submit those to PMI, but then they will evaluate it. You need to talk to the MBA schools and ensure that those institutions are giving you those which are recognized by PMI to qualify you for those 35 hours. But with the 35 hours has to be there, otherwise you cannot sit for the PMP. Your application will not go through. And we talked about initially that why they are mandating these 35 hours of training.
Got it. Very much clear now.
Okay, I think let's wrap up. I don't see any further questions here. Okay, thanks everyone for dialing.